Hello and welcome to my channel. The search bar logo reveal is what we are going to create today. Let's see how to create this using After Effects. Before further proceeding, I would like to thank you for supporting me. If you are new to this channel, please do consider subscribing. That would be highly appreciated. Please don't skip the video. Please do watch the video completely. Let's not waste any more of the time. Let's get started. Create a new composition, call it a search bar. I am setting a 1920 by 1080 composition with a frame rate of 30 and a duration of 10 seconds. Create a new solid layer and name it as background. Search for fill effect and apply it into the solid layer. Choose any color of your choice, I am choosing white. Select the ellipse tool and set the fill to none and stroke to solid color. Create a circle. To create a perfect circle, hold shift key while creating the shape. Center align the circle and apply the fill effect. I will stay with the red color. Select the pen tool and create another shape like this. Position it accordingly and apply the fill effect. Open up shape 1 layer and click on add and choose trim paths. Open up trim paths and at the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for end property with 0 value. Go to around 20 frames and set the end value to 100%. Select the two keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open up graph editor and change the graph as shown. Open up the contents and select ellipse 1. Open up the stroke 1 and set the line cap to round cap. Open up the shape 2 layer and change the line cap to round cap. Click on add and choose trim paths. Open the trim paths and create a keyframe for end property at 5 frames with 0%. Go to around 25 frames and set the end value to 100%. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Ramp preview this. This is what we want. Grab the pen tool and create a horizontal straight line. To create a perfect horizontal line, hold shift key. Set the line cap to round cap. Add trim paths. At 5 frame mark, create a keyframe for end property with 0%. And at the 25 frame mark, set the end value to 100%. At 10 frame mark, create a keyframe for start property with 0%. And at the 1 second mark, set the start value to 100%. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now ramp preview this. I would like to have the animation much more faster, and so I'm decreasing the time. Yeah, that's good. Duplicate the shape layer as many as times as you want. Offset the duplicated shape layers as shown. Also change the positions as you wish. Select all the four line layers and right click and click on pre-compose. Name them as line assets and click OK. Duplicate the line assets composition and adjust the position as shown. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's looking good. Apply the fill effect to the line assets compositions and choose whatever color you wish. I will stay with the red color. In order to create a search bar, select the rectangle tool and set the fill to solid color and stroke to none. And create a shape layer as shown. Apply the fill effect and change the color as you wish. I'm changing it to a lighter gray color. Center align the search bar. Press T to bring up the opacity property. And at the 1 second mark, set the opacity value to 0% and create a keyframe. Go to 1 second 15 frame mark and set the opacity value to 100%. Select the shape 1 layer and shape 2 layer and right click and click on pre-compose and name it as search tool. Press P to bring up the position property. At the 9 frame mark, create a keyframe for position value for the pre-compose layer, and at the 17 frame mark, change the position values as shown. Also move the opacity keyframes of the rectangular shape layer as shown. It seems the search bar is too big, so I am reducing the size. Center align it. Press P to bring up the position properties of the line assets layers and create keyframes for the position values at the 9 frame mark, and at the 17 frame mark, set the position values as shown. I am changing the color of the search bar. Open the search bar. Open the rectangle path of the shape layer 3 and set the roundness to around 70. Yeah, that's looking good. Now RAM preview this. I am bringing in the last keyframe of the opacity property much more closer so that the animation takes place much more faster. Select all the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's good. Press S to bring up the scale property and create a keyframe for scale with 100% at the 20 frame mark, and at the 13 frame mark, set the scale value to 0%. Now select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. RAM preview this. Create a new text layer and type in your text. I am typing in raudran.com. Change the font size to fit into the search bar. Search for typewriter effect and apply it into the text layer. Press U to bring up the keyframes and bring the keyframes much more closer so that the animation takes place much more faster. Create a new composition and name it as Circle Burst Assets. Select the ellipse tool and set the fill to none and stroke to solid color and create a circle as shown. Press S and press Shift T to bring up the scale and opacity property, and at the 15 frame mark, create a keyframe for scale and opacity values. Go to the start of the timeline and set the opacity and scale value to 0%. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's good. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Open the shape 1 layer. Open up the ellipse one. And in the stroke one, at the start of the timeline, set the stroke width to 100 and create a keyframe. go to the 15 frame mark and set the stroke width value to 0. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Duplicate the shape layers as many as times as you want and offset them. Also change their positions and place them wherever you like. Select all the layers and press S to bring up the scale property and change the scale values as you like. Open the search bar composition and bring in the circle bus assets into the timeline. Offset the composition as you like. Search for fill effect and apply it into the layer. Duplicate the circle bust composition and offset it and set the color to different colors. Also, I am changing the duplicated layer's scale property to 50%. To RAM preview this. That's good. It's looking nice. Create a new composition and name it as pop-up transition. Select the ellipse tool and set the fill to solid color and stroke to none and create a circle. To create a perfect circle, hold shift key, center align the circle. At the start of the timeline, create a keyframe for scale value and set it to 0%. At the 10 frame mark, set the scale value so that the circle entirely fills the composition. Select the keyframes and press F9 to easy ease them. Open the graph editor and change the graph as shown. Duplicate the shape layer and offset it to around 4 frames. And set the track mat of the underlying layer to alpha inverted shape layer 2. Create another composition and name it as main. Bring in the search bar composition and the pop-up transition compositions into the timeline. Search for fill effect and apply it into the pop-up transition composition. Offset the pop-up transition where the transition has to take place. I would like to have the transition to take place after the text gets typed. Trim the search bar composition till the transition takes place. Now RAM preview this. Yeah, that's good. I have imported my logo intro. If you want to know how I made this intro, check the description. I will leave a link in the description for the tutorial of which I have made this logo intro. Bring in the logo intro to the timeline. Offset it after the transition takes place and RAM preview this. That's it. That's it, we have created a search bar, logo intro. Hope you enjoyed this video. Let's see the output once again. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook. I will leave a link in the description. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. And also click on the bell icon so that you get notified as soon as I post the videos. Click on the like button and share it with your friends. Comment down if you have anything to ask. And once again, thanks for being here and supporting me. This is Raudran signing off.